Here's a better argument than me smacking Vitaly upside the head with a baseball bat. There, I did get it on the record just for you. Pizza. To eat a pizza, you can start out by eating half of the pizza, but you can take that pizza and divide it in half again, that half of a piece. In fact, you can keep dividing it into smaller and smaller and smaller slices, which would suggest that there's an infinite number of slices. But is it possible for a group of people to finish off an entire pizza? Yes. So it seems that there are some series that go forever that reach a total. We say they converge. And there are some series, Brett, that go forever that don't reach a total. Here's an example of a series that would never reach a total. 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64. Are my numbers just getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger? I think when you add up bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger stuff, I think that eventually reaches or approaches infinity. But what Zeno suggested in his little argument that I started this class out with is, if you're adding up smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller stuff, in some cases, you'll approach an answer. So, David buys a pizza. He eats half of the pizza, then half of the remaining piece, then half of the remaining piece, etc. Continuing in this way, it looks like he will never finish the pizza because there will always be half of a piece left. Explain why in practice this could not happen. Well, you can eat a pizza. It says, represent this situation with a geometric series whose first term is a half. Normally, I would love to walk through all this, but because I'm hoping to go over the trig test with you a bit later on in class, I'm going to say, turn to page 183. Page 183. Okay. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to write two series. The first one, Brandon, give me a number between 1 and 10. 5, 15. Comma. Oh, but instead of commas, I'm sorry, let's put plus signs. Plus 15 plus, what am I multiplying each term by? 45 plus 135 dot dot dot. Here, R equals 3. What do you notice about your terms? Each successive term is getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. Compare that with series number 2. I'll start with, 5, comma, plus, keep doing that, sorry. 1/5 plus 1/25 plus 1/125, dot, dot, dot. What's R in this case? How can I find R always? Any term divided by the one in front of it. Oh, you know what? I made a mistake in my series, didn't I? Cross out the 5, make it a 1. Is right. You know what R is in this case, folks? If I'd done the math correctly, R is 1/5. Amy, what do you notice about the terms here? Are they getting bigger or are they getting smaller? Smaller. We say this first series here diverges. We say this second series here converges. And you can tell just by looking at R. If R is a fraction, your series will converge to a given value eventually. If R is a number bigger than 1, not a fraction, your series will diverge We're going to write that a bit more formally in part B. Okay? It says this. Your sequence will converge, is convergent, and approaches the value, it says, zero, if R blank comma blank. You know what? I like this statement here. R will converge if your ratio is between negative 1 and positive 1. If it's a fraction, but it could be a negative fraction, Dina. The easier way to write that is to say if the absolute value of R is less than 1, because that includes the negative or the positive. R will get bigger, R to the n will get bigger, which means your series will diverge if R is bigger than positive 1 or less than negative 1. Or absolute value of R is greater than 1. It seems confusing for a little bit. Patience, young grasshoppers. Turn the page. Provided that R is between negative 1 and positive 1. How can you figure out R? Any term divided by the 1 in front of it. You can actually add up an infinite number of terms using this here. What does the letter S stand for? What did it stand for last unit? The sum, except last lesson, Elizabeth, it was S with a little N right there saying the number of terms. Do you notice there's no subscript there? It's saying all of them. If you keep going to infinity, it's the first term divided by 1 minus R. There is a lovely proof right there. I just don't have time to walk through it. I do have time to show you how to use this. So here's the geometric series we've learned so far. If it's a finite series, if I tell you how many terms, or Nick, I tell you the last term, use one of these two. You know what? I like that L a bit better than the one on the previous lesson, which looked like a 1. At least that thick stands out. If R is a fraction between negative 1 and positive 1, or the absolute value of R is that, you can find the infinite sum the same way as I was able to smack Vitaly. What was R in my example? A half with Vitaly, because I kept saying half of a 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 half. If R is bigger than 1 or less than negative 1, or the absolute value of R is bigger than 1, it won't converge. You can only find a finite sum. Let's use this. Page 185. Example 1. It says, find the common ratio for each of the following geometric series. Let's do that first. What's R here? 1/3? Oh, hopefully you were clever enough to go 1/3 divided by 1, not 1/9 divided by 1/3, even though you get the same answer. What's R here? Negative 5, yes? What's R here? Negative a half. Which of these will converge? Which of these can you actually take an infinite sum of? Which of these have common ratios that are fractions less than 1? Okay, so this one here diverges. This one here is going to be the infinite sum. I'll even put a little infinity as my subscript, which is an 8 on its side. You don't have to. You can leave it totally blank. But it's going to be A all over 1 minus R. What's A? What's A? 1? What's 1 minus R in your head, please? What's 1 minus 1/3? 2/3. You can do some of them in your head. In fact, I could now say, how do I divide by a fraction, flip it, and multiply? I could put this one on a non-calc section and feel comfortable with it. But the answer on your calculator, or how do I divide by a fraction, flip it, and multiply, is 3/2 or 1.5, is it not? Get your calculator out, all of you. If you don't have a calculator, sheepishly come get one. No takers. Okay. Got your calculator out? I want you to notice how fast this does approach 1.5. So go 1 plus 1/3 and hit enter. And then add 1/9 and hit enter. And then add, what would come after 1/9? Can you do the math? 1/27 and hit enter. Plus, what would come after 1/27? 1/3 to the 4th, 81. Plus 1/3 to the 5th. I'm just continuing the pattern. Plus, I mean, we're at 1.5 basically right now. Plus, and we're only on our, what, 6th term, 5th term? It converges pretty fast. Plus 1/3 to the 6th would be the next one. Plus 1/3 to the 7th would be the next term. Here's my, I've only added now, I believe, 8 terms, and I'm at 1.499. They converge pretty fast. Think about that. The first 8 terms gave you 1.499. The remaining infinity terms only add up to 0.00022862363685 ... The nerd within me finds that kind of cool. Infinity behaves weird. B won't converge. It won't have an infinite sum. C will. Let's find it. So the infinite sum is equal to A all over 1 minus R. You know what? On the previous page, in keeping with my tradition, since this is on your formula sheet, I should have put a big highlighter around that. Yes? Forgot. And it's weird that my brain twigged me right then, right now. Don't ask me how my brain works. It's frightening sometimes. If you continued this pattern forever and kept adding, what would you get? Let's see, it's going to be 2 all over 1 minus a half. That's the same as 1 plus a half. You know what? 1 plus a half is 3 over 2, or 1.5. Does the answer to that? The sum of infinity. There are other types of series that converge, but there's a whole sub-branch of math which does nothing but try and prove ahead of time, mathematically, which series converge and which series diverge. Who's in calculus? Really important in limits. So in probably second or third year calc, you'll start taking the limit of a series. Not nice, clear, easy ones like this, but of a series where, oh, the denominator is actually a function, an equation. Ooh, cool! Or not. Example 2. The first term of a geometric series is 2. Oh, A equals 2. And the sum to infinity is 4. I guess that means that S equals 4. What do they want me to find here? R. How do I know which S formula to use? The one from last day or the one today? Well, the key is they said the sum to infinity, which means I'm going to use the infinite sum equation. But I need a bit more room. Let's plug stuff in. What's S, the sum to infinity? 4 equals, what's A? 2 all over 1 minus R. Can anyone tell me how to solve this?
Please, please, please.
Oh, yeah. Good old cross multiply. We'll get 2 equals 4 bracket 1 minus R. 2 equals, I could divide by 4. I'm going to go to brackets here. 4 minus 4R. The reason is, Brandon, I've done this style of equation so much since grade 8, I think. Now I can do this in my head. Minus 4 from both sides, and then divide by negative 4, yes? R is going to end up being 2 take away 4 divided by negative 4. Oh, in lowest terms, I guess R is a half. Now, 3a and b is actually a neat application. You can use this to write fractions that go on forever, because this is really 0.07 plus 0.007 plus 0.0007 plus 0.00007, where r is 1/10. And then you can solve for s, and you'll get an answer as a fraction. And now you go, oh, that's what that was as a repeating decimal. I sadly don't have time because I want to go through your trig test. So very quickly, homework 1A, B, C. M. Three and four are mini curveballs. Seven, A part 1, 2, and 3, but don't worry about B. And 9.